Okay, guys, so today we're going to go for a quick little ride in my 2008 BMW M3 here. Just want to give you guys an idea of how it drives, what it's like to drive, and just a few little features about it. So it's an Alpine white exterior, 19-inch rims. The nice angel eye headlights, and not too many modifications, just it's on lowering springs, as you guys can probably see, tinted windows, and the RPI exhaust, which sounds really good. So stepping right in, it's a real nice step in height, everything's good there. Very nice seats. I love these fox red looks. It goes great with the Alpine white, and that's all black. Premium package, so you get this kind of carbon fiber threading look. That's very nice. Buckle up here. Okay, so keyless start, keyless entry as well. Forgot to mention that. So you just need to have the key in your pocket, clutch in, and you can go right up to start. And you'll notice the it's got an adaptive red line here, so actually it'll move down as it warms up to the full red line of like 8300 RPMs down here, and but right now it's obviously pretty cold, so it's all the way up there. So that's one little feature. So let's go for a little drive. Okay, so this is a great, just the whole setup of the transmission, the clutch, everything feels very nice, and it's just really easy to drive. I haven't driven one of these M3s before we bought, ended up buying this one, and the first time I started driving this car, I was very impressed. Just everything is very simple to drive, clutch is very forgiving. It's not hard at all. Another cool feature I like is this hill start, active hill start, so it'll oop, little car behind me. So it'll just hold the brake basically while you do the clutch, so it makes it very easy on hills. Not that we have a whole lot around here, but it's a nice little feature, makes it easy to drive in that regard. And another thing, this M mode right here, that lets you obviously customize your M setting basically. So that puts it into your steering mode, throttle response, suspension. So mine, when I click it on, it's got all that. Everything's on Sport or Sport Plus. So it really changes the dynamics of the car, which is very nice. And it kind of turns into a whole nother beast. You'll see power's on, EDC, it's got that option. I think it's like $2,000 or $3,000 option on this car. So luckily ours has it. So that changes the suspension from kind of a more comfort ride to a really sporty ride as it is now. So the other thing, the steering, it's got a speed adjustable kind of steering, so when you're at very low speeds, it's really nice, very light, easy to maneuver, and that's kind of really, it just makes it really nice when you're around town. It's not a pain in the butt at all. And then when you get up to speed, it's got this real nice weight to it. Okay, so a couple other things I want to note are with these seats, these are the these fox red seats, these are the BMW's M Sport seats, so they actually have adjustable bolsters. So down here, if you can tell, you just move that in, and right now they are just clamping in on me. So that's one other thing I like about these seats. It's fully warmed up here, and we're on a nice little road here, so I'll be quiet and let the car do some of the docking, but it's just a blast. course I need gas. God dang. This thing gets terrible miles per gallon. Terrible MPG. I don't know. Right now we're probably getting like 10 or something. Maybe less. I don't know. On the highway, and if you're not hitting it, it does okay. Right now it's, pretty bad. Yeah, it just loves to be revved. Just one incredible engine this motor is. I mean, 4-liter naturally aspirated V8, 8,400 RPM red line. I mean, it really doesn't get much better than that. I mean, these things are legendary for a reason, and they're just a blast to play around with. And the suspension is all very nice and tight. Wow. Jeez. And the other thing is, it can be a beast back there, but people daily drive these things all the time. 4 seats. Everything you'd want. So overall, we've had a blast with this car so far. Haven't had it for too long, but it's just a real, real gem. Fun car. No wonder these things are just such a, everybody wants to have them just because they're, man, you cannot beat the sound. The performance is great. Just what a fun car. And they're not a whole lot of money either. I mean, 20, 25 grand for a real cheap one, 25, 30, 35 grand for a real nice one. And you can get the 7-speed dual clutch, or the 6-speed manual. And the 6-speed is really great though. There's a reason so many people just go ape over it. Just real nice throws. Everything feels really good with it. Clutch is fine. Everything's just real nice to drive. So if you guys have one of these, you know what I'm talking about. And if you don't, you definitely want to drive in one, or you know, drive one. If you live near Washington, D.C., hit me up. I'd love to give you guys a ride, as always. But yeah, definitely. So thanks for watching this video. I just wanted to put up a quick little point of view, kind of drive, little just run with this car. I haven't driven it in a while, so I figured that'd be a good time to give it a little drive. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. And as always, you know, stay tuned, because we got a ton more stuff coming. With this car, the Audi S6, our other BMW, our 3 Porsches, including the LS6 swap, which is a nuts car, and our friend Andrew is coming back from college in a couple weeks here, and he's got a super nice Mazda Speed 3. With some really tasteful mods with, I think it's like 400 horsepower, 400 horsepower, 400 pound feet of torque. It's something crazy like that. So I'm excited to make some videos with that one. I hope you guys are too. So we got a ton of footage coming with all those cars combined. And we're getting off school here soon, so this will be a fun time for some real nice videos. All right, we'll catch you guys later.